This is the second video of the Creating an Animated Illustration tutorial series. Select the mesh, and delete the default vertices. Add vertices to match the shape of the image. If you add vertices as if you are doing 3D modeling, this may be useful when applying the morph modifier. Since mechanical objects have generally less curved faces, you do not need to add a lot of vertices. Add vertices for the robot arm. Rather than being too detailed, it is better to express a basic shape. I recommend that you make meshes as a box, cylinder, or etc. I made all the fingers of the robot's hand as meshes. I will make these fingers move nicely later on. Creates vertices of a hair mesh. Rather than making all the hair one by one, I made a mesh like a wide cloth. Now let's do the same for the rest of meshes. The arm has 3 joints from shoulder to wrist, so you need to make more vertices. The back of the skirt has fewer vertices. When creating vertices about the lower body mesh, you should create it with the care that the legs and pelvis move naturally. Just like 3D modeling, creating the vertices of the pelvis and legs is a little trickier. When making a leg, let's make it with the care of joints as if making an arm. If this part of the work is burdensome, it is also good to separate the pelvis and legs. As the most complicated process, it is time to make a skirt of dress. I emphasized this point when creating vertices because I have drawn a fairly voluminous skirt. Added vertices by separating the front and bottom of the skirt. The bottom of the skirt added vertices to show the wrinkles, making the upper side somewhat simpler. The layered cloth covering the skirt was described relatively simply. The process of making the upper body is relatively easy. Vertices will be added a little bit more, but you can make the mesh easily because the body has gently curved faces. If you create a character to be applied to the game, you have to add a lot of vertices to the waist. But when you animate an illustration, you do not have to take the exaggerated action of the characters, so you can do it simply. Let's also make meshes for the face and eyes. If the character blinks, it looks like a very high quality animation. However, since the face, eyes, and hair are quite smaller than the whole screen, it is not necessary to make them very detailed. Meshes are all created. This process took a really long time. Bake the character and go to the next step. Let's add a screen effect. If you are using Unity 5, select Effects under Import Package in the Assets menu. When the package contents are displayed, click the Import button. Select the camera and insert Bloom from the added scripts. When a script is added, you can see that the light parts of the screen is more lightened. You can add other effects. Let's add and test various scripts that have screen effects. Next is how to apply effects in the Unity 2018 version. Select the Package Manager menu from the window menu. When you select all packages in the list on the left, all installable packages will appear. Select the Post Processing package and click the Install button. Select the camera and add the Post Process layer component. Change the layer from Nothing to Everything. Add a new game object. Add the Post Process Volume component. Turn on the Is Global property. Press the new button of the profile property, and select the created profile. Now you can add screen effects to this profile. Let's add bloom once. By default, the options are off, so turn on the required options and adjust the values. Now you can configure a nice screen like the illustration.